Hi, we're going to take a deeper look at the Java number class. In this tutorial, we'll focus on the Java number constants available in the Java integer and Java float classes. There are many number classes. We saw that in the autoboxing and unboxing tutorial. For this tutorial, we're going to focus on the integer and float classes. That keeps the material simpler. The functionality available in the integer and float classes is also available in the other Java number classes. Let's start with the constants in the integer class. The integer class has a minimum and maximum value. The constants are max value and min value. We can remember this usually as -2 to the -31 and 2 to the +31, -1, but we don't want to calculate the power every time we need to use it. If we need the actual value, that's what these constants are for. They represent the maximum and minimum values for the primitive type. We'd use these in programs where we need to protect against edge cases. For example, if we're looking for the smallest number in the list, we might set the initial value to the largest. We know that every value in this list should be smaller than or equal to the max value. When we run the loop and look at every number in the list, we have an initial value to compare against. If we're looking for the largest number, we just start with the smallest number and look for numbers that are bigger. The bytes and size constants tell us how large the data type. When working with integers on some machines, we'll have a 32-bit number, others a 16-bit number. It depends on the CPU, version of Java, and so on. For most personal computers, bytes will return 4 and size will return 32 for integers. The long class would be 8 and 64, respectively. The last constant is the class type called type. Class objects are meta objects, and type simply returns a class describing the primitive class wrapped by the enclosing class. The integer also has a method called getClass. GetClass returns a class describing the wrapper class integer. The distinction is getClass is returning the meta class for the wrapper class integer, while type is returning the meta class for the primitive type int. If we print the class name, getClass prints Java lang integer, while typeToString prints int. The reasons for the distinction are important when we get to reflection in Java. That's a ways off, but the idea is if we ask what the class type is for a variable, the integer class is different from the int primitive. If we know that we have a number, we'll use the type constants to determine what kind of primitive the number instance is wrapping. The float class has 7 more constants for a total of 11 constants. The max value and min value return the maximum and minimum numbers represented with a float. Again, these constants are useful in programs where you need to set the edges for your numbers. Bytes and size also return the primitive size for the machine, and type still returns a class describing the float class. These all work the same way for floats. If you remember the Java floating point numbers intricacy lesson, a floating point number is separated into different bit fields. These bit fields represent the sign, exponent, and mantissa. Java provides constants for the maximum and minimum exponent. For most machines, max exponent for floats is 127 and min exponent is -128. Min normal is a bit more complicated. Remember, the mantissa has an implied bit, almost always 1. So the smallest number we can represent looks like this. The exponent is 1 minus the bias of 127, which equals -126. The mantissa is all zeros, and using the implied bit, we get 1 × 2⁻²⁶. If the exponent is all zeros, the implied mantissa bit is also zero. When the implied bit is zero, the mantissa is called denormalized. In this case, the smallest number that you can represent changes. The exponent is 0 minus the bias 127, which equals -127. And the last bit is the smallest bit we can use, since the number is now normalized. The smallest positive float is 1 × 2⁻⁴. That's a huge difference in the smallest number representable. This is used so we can get more numbers that are near zero at the expense of accuracy. The last three constants for the float class are all about representing impossible numbers. That's positive infinity, negative infinity, and not a number. These constants are the IEEE representations for the float primitive. These constants are returned by some trigonometric and logarithmic functions. All right, if you have any questions, add them to the comments below. Next, we'll look at Java number conversions. So, liking this video helps me know that I'm doing things right. So if you like the video, you know what to do. Don't forget to subscribe to the DGU newsletter. In each newsletter, I'll send out a summary of the videos for that month and tips and news not included in the videos. All right, I'll see you in the next tutorial.